Hi everyone, this is Cherry Enchantress. I am here with a book. And alright, so this is going to be a little bit different. This is like a future projection book kind of thing. Let me set this up a little bit so you can see my picture. Okay, so this is kind of not part of the subject, but if you want to donate to my Patreon, you can go check that out and see that this is like the beginning drawing that I did and digitally enhanced it and did kinds of, you know, different things to it to create that small little thumbnail that I have for the people who want to support me, the platinum pixies that want to support me. So yeah, if you're so inclined, please, yes, please pledge as a platinum pixie. I would be so excited if you did that. Okay, so here is a book. And this book is The Science of Getting Rich by Walter D. Wattles. And I just want to say that I've never been one that's really cared about money too much. You know, I was raised a lot like some people that maybe money was the root of all evil, or that money isn't important. What's more important is love, you know, things like that. So my parents were fine, you know, they did well, but it was a big fluctuation. My mom had a steady, stable job. She was a teacher. My dad, he was full of ego, so he had to have jobs that really fulfilled him. And pardon my street noise. My dad's job, my parents both were opera singers, but they kind of focused on opera differently. My dad was a solo artist, so he only sang lead roles. My mom was a choral worker, so she had very constant work. She was always one of the village people on stage singing at night, and then in the daytime she was a teacher. So she worked a lot. She was a very independent working mother. And my dad, he tried all kinds of odd jobs, but, you know, singing was his passion. That was his only true love and passion, and he would get frustrated a lot. So I had two polarities when it came to money, when it came to faith, when it came to all of that. My dad was on the negative side. My mom was on the positive side. Occasionally, my dad would come across to the light and say, you know, positive things and be more of a positive person. But generally, he believed that it was realistic to be negative. So I and half of me was raised that way. I tended to lean more towards my mom because I liked the optimism. The optimism made me feel good, you know. The pessimism made me feel bad, and I didn't want to feel bad, you know. I didn't care if it was safer. I didn't want to feel bad, you know. So interesting way that I saw money. It seemed like sometimes we had and sometimes we didn't, but I never suffered. I never went without. I always had food and a roof over my head and lots of love, and we had parties, and I mean, I had a wonderful childhood, so I didn't ever feel a lack of anything. But a lot of times my dad talked about a lack, you know, whether I felt it or not. So anyway, so when it comes to money, you have your background, the way you're raised has a lot to do with how you focus on this this word abundance and money and attracting it and all of that. So when you you're doing these readings with me or anybody else, and you are seeing, you know, things about pentacles, money, whatever, the way your mind works kind of funny when it comes to money. You know, not everybody has the same view of it, and not everybody has a positive view on money. So that's why. So I'm gonna, it's kind of like this interesting ripple effect, and I wrote it down so I could keep track of this ripple effect. Okay, so first I meet Melanie Williams on the on her site on Indigo Tarot Oddessey. And just listen to her stuff, and the way she, like I said, the way she said things, created really beautiful pictures in my head. I was like, whoa, this is nice. You know, I'm feeling I'm feeling this manifesting vibe. I'm feeling like I can draw this in. I feel it, you know. It's right there. It's right there. It's in my hands. And she spoke, you know, and still does, about everything from, you know, love, romance, twin flames, all the way to career, money, finances, abundance, so on, you know. And so that was a great beginning of manifesting this idea of money. Then she mentioned, you know, I had already known about The Secret. I had already known about manifestations, the law of attraction, and all of that. And so I used it to the best of my ability, but I knew there was more, that I needed more practice with it. I needed to keep working at it. It's not something that you can just learn and just assume that you'll fall into good habits, because sometimes you have to create constant habits when it comes to manifesting. So when she talked about Jake Ducey and went over to his site, and at first I was like, another one of these guys, you know. But I gave him a chance, you know, listened to him, and he seems a really sweet guy, like a super sweet guy. And one of his videos, the way he talked about money was exactly the way I was raised. He was raised the same way as me, like about his relationship with money and how he didn't feel like he needed it, like it wasn't important, like he couldn't really grasp the concept of money. Funny with me, it's like the house of money is what I've learned is like the second house of finances, money. That's the house of Taurus. And my son is in the second house, but guess what else? My Pisces, Neptune is in the second house. So I had a comment once back in this group forum that I belonged in, that money can play tricks, be tricky with me because of that, because of this sort of dreamy, esoteric way I was looking at money. I wasn't looking at it like a material, or even like energy, like how I've been hearing more lately. Money is energy. Money is energy, and energy is good. It's not evil. It is, you know, we have a currency. We have a connection with each other through this money, and it's like a support, and it's a network kind of thing. It's a real interesting way that, you know, that we are connected. Another material sort of way that we're connected, not so much a spiritual way, but the spirit comes within the energy, and it comes within our connection and this positivity and this light and this joy of sharing. So, you know, and then I had a really great Christmas that I had a lot of abundance. I had a lot of money and I had a lot to give. I was giving to donations. I bought everybody a gift. It felt wonderful, you know, this really give and take flowing of money, of things, you know. Just, I know things are just things, but to be able to give and receive causes an amazing kind of energy between us as friends, family, people, whatever. So my point of view on money is changing quite a bit. And so Jake was Jake was saying about, you know, his experience and what changed his mind about money. So here's how this ripple effect goes. So he stumbled upon a book by Jen Sincero called You're a Badass at Making Money, okay? And he was attracted to Jen Sincero's story, which she was sort of this punk rocker type of girl who lived in a garage, and she was like, you know, F the system or whatever, you know, like she was just like really, she thought it was part of her persona not to care about money, not to care about any of that, that, you know, it to be poor was part of, and suffering was part of, you know, the art and the music and whatever she was going through. You know, a lot of people feel that way out there too. You know, it's like, you know, you can't sing the blues unless you've suffered or something. I know somebody who's told me that, and maybe, you know, maybe that's true to a certain sense. I don't know. Like, if you're really, really in touch with your feelings, you can feel the blues no matter what happens in your life. You can feel the blues. So, and you can sing the blues. I mean, you can sing the blues because you can feel it somewhere in that place. You know what the blues is like. So, people who are in touch with their spirit and people who are in touch with their heart, they can do anything without suffering. You don't have to suffer to know what it feels like, right? So anyway, Jen Cisneros, I'm not sure exactly what her mind frame was, but Jake said he read her book, You're a Badass at Making Money, and it tells her story. And I have not read that book, and I'm going to order that. But I thought I should start. I thought I should start at this book, because in her book, You're Bad at It, Making Money, she talks about Wallace Wattles, how he affected her. And when she read his book, she was pissed off. She was like, you know, he's full of BS. Like, you know, I don't believe money is like this or whatever. I don't believe in this. But for some reason, she was attracted to this book, and she bought this book, and she read it, and it changed her life, and she was able to make money and so on and so forth. One of the things that Jen Cisneros said, Wallace Wattles had said some very controversial things in his book. He's saying, basically, you have to be rich in order to get anywhere in life or whatever, and that would rub me the wrong way too, you know, like, because I believe in love is above everything, but it makes a lot of sense, and you know, it makes sense. You can't dismiss money, you can't dismiss this currency between us. So Jen was thinking, I have a right to be rich, and then she was talking about the word desire. She had a desire, and the word desire comes from of the Father. So then she was like trying to associate it with God and not the devil. You know, money is, and this abundance and everything is, comes from the universe. It comes from God. It comes from a good place. So that's the way I'm starting to see it. And I would like you guys to see it too, because I want you guys to also have wealth and abundance. So this is not a book I've read yet, but it is going to be on my Books That Changed My Life series. So yeah, I waited. It's funny. Good things are worth waiting for, right? I waited for this book. It didn't come. I contacted Amazon. I'm like, what's going on with my book? And it's like, oops, it got lost. You know, I'm like, well, I really want to read it. I wanted to read this during the Christmas holiday. And they're like, okay, well, we'll send you another one. So they sent me another one, and it came about a week ago. In the meantime, I've been reading some other books, so I just decided to put this off for a little bit because I wanted to do this video first for you and tell you this is going to be on my list of Books That Changed My Life series. You wait and see. So it could be one of the books that change your life too, The Science of Getting Rich, guys. So I hope it does. I hope it helps. And I shouldn't say hope, because Jake said there's certain words that we use all the time that we need to stop using, and hope is one of them. I'm not going to hope anymore. I'm just going to know. I know it will. I didn't get it because I hoped it will. I got it because I know it will. They're just like Yoda says, there, do or do not, there is no try. You know, you just do it. You do it and you know it. You're not just trying. You do it. You do it, right? Go to the gym. Do it. I'm going to go to the gym. All right, so guys, I hope you like that little talk on this book. And I hope it helps you to motivate attracting money into your life this new year. I feel like you a lot of you out there are seeing things in a different way and seeing things in a positive way. And there's enough, the universe has enough for everybody. You know, there's not anyone out there that deserves it more than anybody else. We all do. Okay, guys, we all do. So just focus on that. Do your meditations, your attractions, your affirmations, and, you know, reading books also just helps really get your mind in that focus. You know, reading the words, seeing the words, writing the words down helps your mind focus. Listening to affirmations, whatever it takes, music that attracts money. They have that kind of music that you can sleep with at night, and I do that too. It kind of gives me a peaceful place, but If it helps me attract abundance, so be it. Let it come to me. Okay, so faith, trust, and pixie dust.